this chap right here was the first person I killed in Blaviken. It's the same performance.
Tomasz. Yeah.
And his head is back intact again. Hello, I'm Henry Cavill, and I play Geralt of Rivia on The Witcher.
And I'm Wolfgang Stegemann. I'm the second unit director and stunt coordinator of The Witcher Season 3.
Together, Wolfie and I are going to break down a fight scene, which you probably have seen already, but we wanted to show you what went into the making of it. It is a one-take fight. There are no cuts in here. There's no cheat cuts either. There's nothing like just someone crossing in front of camera and then you can make it look like it's a one-take. The beauty of a one-take is that it can allow the audience members to feel truly involved in the dance of death that is happening.
In the beginning, we sat down together and thought about how we can do this one take. How can we build the dynamic? How we can create like a symphony, it's like composing a symphony, let's call it like this.
Because it's such a large battle scene, it's not just Geralt interacting with, it's 12 people.
Actually, 13.
13.
The 13 one is the camera operator.
Of course, yes. Yes. And Hachi did an amazing job on this. He has to move incredibly quickly, and he also has to be in the right position at all times because he doesn't want to get hit by a spear or a sword.
We basically call it like a living camera. The camera is living in the sequence, and it's a constantly part of the fight.
It's what makes Wolfgang's work and his team's work unique, is that the camera is alive and it's constantly adapting. There might be some stuff here which wasn't part of the plan, which Hachi is finding with his naked eye as he's working on the camera as well.
He had no monitor. He's running through the fight and need to imagine with the right lens size where he has to be in the right moment.
It's truly exceptional work. And especially if you compare our training footage to the footage which you see here in the finished product, the ground is very different.
Yes.
And with the ground being different and with extra bodies being in, see, in this frame here, you can see there's two people on the ground here. And there's a third one there. And Hachi has to step over these people, or they have to get out of his way.
Oh, they have to, exactly. Yeah. They, even if they're dead on the ground, they need to roll out.
And then look the same dead as they looked before when they're back on camera.
Exactly. The problem is with those fights, and you go further away with the camera, you see the background and you think, oh, what is this guy doing there? So he needs to come in the right moment.
Yes.
And this is very difficult because they need to fight in the background and suddenly approach you.
If you watch carefully in a lot of projects, you'll see a stunt performer, whether it's an actor or another stunt performer, they stand up behind them. Mm-hmm. They sort of do this sort of fake movement because they're waiting and they can't go straight for the attack.
They do 1, 2, 3 beat. And
Where in reality, they'd go in and just hit the person on the back of the head. But this way, we can have stunt performers waiting behind camera or taking their time to get up and set for an attack. And all of this is playing in all of our heads at the same time. So it's not as simple as running in there and just doing a dance. It's running in there and making sure the timing works. We actually built in originally some slow motion, some fake slow-mo moments where I would move in slow motion and we'd use a ramp in post to speed it up, and it allowed Hachi to get into a position, or at least allowed Hachi a moment of breath so he could move it into the right position.
But it didn't suit really this fight.
Right.
Because we wanted to keep this like in real speed and not start tweaking or tuning it.
Right.
So when you see that fight, it's like, this is like the true speed.
And at times, actually, the full speed was too fast. You get, you end up getting a lot of adrenaline and quite aggressive in these scenes. And so you want to do it at full aggression and full speed, but sometimes it doesn't look good for camera. Here, see, if this was any faster, that gets completely lost.
To design or compose this, we needed to have those little breaks and the power beats in between.
Which allow you, the viewer, to catch up with what's happened. Otherwise, it's just a bit breathtaking. You go, I think I know what happened, but it gives you time.
Basically, it's like an ocean with waves. So
there's a power beat.
Exactly. We give a break where you step in and turn and pull out the sword.
We worked very hard at making sure we involved more of the signs in here. There's an Ard in there. There's a heliotrope, which is from the books. We designed it as more of an overall shield rather than just a forward shield. So this heliotrope. We also had Igni in here as well, and we really wanted to make sure that Geralt used his full range of skills and abilities.
Yes.
Why would he hold anything back, especially when he's going to go chase Ciri here? In some of the other fights, we have him making non-lethal strikes, but this one, it's all death because Ciri's in danger. And it's all about maiming people or killing them because he's got to take them out of the fight. That's 35 takes on the day. And then in training, we probably did 90 takes. And so that's the wonder of working with such a quality team is that because it's a dance, if someone's slightly out of position, you then move to meet them in their position. And that requires a trust, and your team is so good, and you are so good, that it allows a sense of freedom to create something as balletic as this.
Yeah. It's like a work flow together.
Yeah.
And this is basically then when we have a good take, then we get all goosebumps.
Yes.
Yeah,
everyone feels it.
Yeah.
Everyone feels it. Thank you very much, everyone, for listening. We hope it was interesting. And we hope, most of all, that you enjoyed the product of our work. So thank you very much.
Yeah. Thank you so much.